All right, for step number two, I'm going to be using these shapes that I cut out and created. I'm going to use them as templates or tracers so that my shapes that go around my color wheel end up all being the same. I'm going to start up here at my number 12 spot. If it was a regular clock, where it would have a number 12 on the clock. And I'm going to line my umbrella up so it's covering that mark. And it's about right in the middle of these two marks that are on either side of it, the number 1 o'clock mark and the number 11 o'clock mark. So I've lined that up and I'm gonna use my hands to hold this really still while I trace my umbrella. Now, of course, with working with a Sharpie, if I shift it and I mess up by accident, I'm kind of out of luck. So that's why I recommend that you work with a pencil so that if you kind of wiggle your shape by accident or something, it's not that big of a deal. See, whoop, yep, I moved it. Now I've got to get it lined back up before I keep going. And I'm just going to finish tracing this umbrella that I drew. I think I'm going to take my own advice and I'm going to switch over to pencil here in a minute and do it in pencil because I'm not doing a very good job of this and I would like to do a better job. All right, so there's one umbrella that I've traced. Of course, now because I'm tracing it, I'm missing some lines that I need to still come in here and add on. Okay, so I'm adding on these lines that I drew in my original design. Okay, and I'm gonna push these raindrops off to the side for a minute. I'm going to skip this mark right here. Okay, and I'm gonna come to the number 2 o'clock mark. And I'm gonna trace my umbrella again. And I'm going to keep going around tracing my umbrella on every other mark. So it's like umbrella, mark, umbrella, mark, umbrella, mark. Okay, so I'm going to finish doing that. So here are my happy little umbrellas. I did do them with pencil first and then went over them with Sharpie. So now that I've finished going over them with Sharpie, anywhere where I still see some pencil lines, I can erase anywhere where maybe like my little circle that I originally drew right here is crossing into my umbrella. I can erase away that so that my circle is still existing outside of my umbrella but no longer inside of my umbrella. It'll just make your project look a little bit nicer. So I can finish erasing away my pencil lines and then I'll be ready to use my next template. So you may have guessed already that you're going to be using your next template, whatever it is that you created, in the in-between shape. So I could use just one of my little water droplets. I could use all three. Maybe sometimes I just use one and maybe sometimes I use two. Maybe sometimes I do use all three. I could also arrange them all the same way every time, or I could kind of change how I'm arranging them. I don't want them to cross over onto my umbrellas at all. I want them to have their own space. So if there's ever a space where I can't fit all three, I'll just do one, okay? If you're having trouble with that where your shape that's gonna go in between your other shapes is too big, you may just have to draw it or cut it a little bit smaller to make it work. And I'm just gonna go around my circle the same way, drawing these shapes as well, adding them onto my drawing so that in the end, I'm gonna have an AB pattern all the way around of my raindrops and then my umbrellas, my raindrops, and then my umbrellas. If anything also like runs off the side of your paper a little bit, that's also okay, that's not a problem. Okay, so I finished tracing this one. I'm gonna go around and finish tracing every time I'm in between two umbrellas. I'm gonna trace either one, two, or three of my little raindrops so that they go all the way around my piece, and then I'll trace those with Sharpie as well. You can see now I've got all of my raindrops drawn as well, and I'm just finishing up on my last little raindrop here. I've gone around and done all the umbrellas already, but I'm just finishing up on these last little raindrops here, erasing anywhere where my pencil lines are still showing from my tracing or where my pencil line maybe was crossing through the middle of my shape. And now that I've got everything drawn, I'm ready to move on to step number three.